this was your speech. Right now, I'm talking to you guys about Arrow Season 6, Episode 6. It's crazy to say that. Promises kept. You know, and right now we just saw the team head out, you know, to stop, you know, the dragon, a.k.a. Ricardo Diaz, a.k.a. the supplier to Diggle's hand trimmer problems, which I think eventually is going to come to a head, full steam ahead, and, you know, Aubrey might just question him about it. And, you know, of course, I'm just now obviously seeing this guy's got here from seeing the Justice League, so be prepared to see some content on that as well. Definitely enjoy it, and I definitely recommend people go see it, because it's just that good of a movie. But, you know, we're just now seeing, you know, the team head out, you know, take out Ricardo Diaz. Now, I will say this as well. There's a lot of big bads this season, you know, so far. You know, you have Anatoly, Black Canary, Vigilante, now you have the Dragon, possibly. So this is pretty cool to see this go full ahead. Just a whole bunch of people, big team up, 5-on-5, you know, Team Arrow against Team Bad Guy. So I'm really excited to see this and see what happens. My thing is, I know Diggle has to be sweating bullets now that they're trying to take down Ricardo Diaz, because, you know, he's trying to cover his own tail. At the same time, you know, still trying to, I guess you could say, arise to the expectations of being the Green Arrow, the leader of the new team, of the team and stuff like that. You know, and to top it all off, you know, his wife, Lila, doesn't know about this either, which I'm really surprised. You know, I think we'll learn more and more that Diggle's not so good at keeping secrets, man, you know. And I think this time when Oliver questions him, possibly on the next episode, when the Dragon makes his debut, Oliver's not going to just walk in there, you know, and not just screw Diggle's head off. He's going to wonder why he's doing this, you know, and how did he get word of this drug, and then some. Because, you know, I remember a couple episodes back, I think it was the first or second episode of this season, you know, we saw a neurologist that's familiar with their work asking how he was doing with neurologically, you know, because of how, you know, the shrapnel and things like that. And that's when Dinah found out about, you know, that Diggle sustained some damage while on BNU. So I'm really interested to see how this all plays out for Diggle. You know, I really wish it wasn't under these kind of circumstances, you know. It's just one of those things, you know. It's just like, why, Diggle, why? Like, but I understand at the same time, you know, he's always been able to perform at his best, you know, never being compromised. You know, Oliver passed the mantle to him temporarily to do his fatherly duties. So, you know, for him to not, you know, arise to those expectations has to get like a lot of pressure on Diggle, you know. You know, he didn't set this up himself, of course not, but you know, imagine your right-hand man, the boss telling you, hey, I'm giving you this mantle, you know, I want you to take over. But also not knowing that, you know, I'm compromised, you know, I don't have a steady hand. So, we'll see how this goes. Dragon got the vial of concoction of the trimmer here. You know, we just heard the Black Canary cry. So, you know, he said, everyone get out of here. You know, make sure nothing gets confiscated. Dinah's taking names, as usual. Can we all just, you know, admire the badassery of Dinah, you know, as the Black Canary? Because not only does she have a staff, but she also has a freaking pistol, son. Now, mind you, Diggle is very conflicted right now. This is what I like to call moral dilemma, I think. Because, you know, that's the cure to his tremors, you know, and he's watching it burn right now. So because now he has no other choice but to let it come clean. You know, we just saw him freeze up right there. You know, that's got to be hurting him right now because, you know, and now Renee sees him just like this again, and I think Felicity knows some stuff is up too, right before the commercial break. No. also have kind of slayed, you know, during, you know, but it's only been up for the last 3 years. Mind you, Oliver Queen, you know, was said to be the hostage because, you know, his son wants, Slade's son, Kane, wants to take out Oliver Queen. Slade, it looks like he's going to be going off against his son. Oh, wow, it's talking about a sibling rivalry. Now, we see Oliver taking names, you know, just gunning people down. He said, how could you forget about this for all he's done to you? He said, because I didn't want to pass on to you. All this anger, you know, all this resentment, boy. Resentment is time to bring to an end, son. No. It's the beginning. So now, Slade and Joe are facing off against each other. This is really messed up, but it has to go down, I guess. And Oliver, of course, is still taking names, defending himself. Of course, he's killing out self-defense. Who doesn't love doing that? You know, when the situation needs to be. Now we see his son versus father fighting. You know, Joe said, you promised me all these things, and then you didn't show up. Like, what happened? He said, I seen you kill before in real world. So you did that Chinese father. So Joe seeing his father killed on their father and son trip traumatized him, obviously. She said, something mother never told you. I have a brother. His name is Grant. But mom didn't want him in this world. Me. I'm my father's son. I'm in my first... I didn't even first go 6 months after that camping trip. I wanted to be just like my father, with Deathstroke. See my way. So Oliver just saved Slade's life. Wish he'd stay dead. So Joe gets away. That was a touching reunion, won't you say? Man, so many, but you know, I understand Joe's resentment, you know, for personal reasons. You know, having a lack of parent, you know, whether mother or father, does have a significant effect on, you know, whether you like to let it be that way or not. You know, people cope with things differently, you know, and Joe, unfortunately, you know, like you said, he made his first true, you know, he made his first big break. You know, 6 months after, you know, that camping trip. So, man, what's to say? Then he said he had a brother named Grant. And I guess he probably killed his brother Grant, I guess. Maybe he's still out there. I hope not. That'd just be downright low. For you to kill your own brother. Like, bro, what the hell? But, you know, you heard him put emphasis on, I'm my father's son, and also you hear him put emphasis on, if you're not Deathstroke anymore, then you're no longer my father. As if he's married, he's so psychologically messed up, you know, that he's literally married to alias, you know, that label, you know, that moniker that Slade Wilson is under. So, you know, when Slade denounced that, he said, well, you're no longer my father because he's yelling against to him. He always knew him as, you know, Deathstroke, you know, of course, the Terminator. So, that's a completely understandable. I just wish, you know, of course, Slade possibly wishes that things weren't the way they are, obviously. I mean, no father would want that, or a parent for that matter. But, wow, this is definitely heavy. I can tell you that. Now Slade just looked at this picture, he said, my son saw me killed before everything started, before Deathstroke. You know, Hopper tells him, don't blame yourself. Touch my phone, son, both of them. I can't give up. You got any of my help again. I didn't think you did. You have your own son to protect. I'm not going to put that at risk again. We'll see what's going to happen. You don't know what's going to happen. So Slade extends his arm out to Oliver. They shake hands. Thank you, kid. I will say this though, seeing the dynamic between Slade and, you know, his son Joe, it sounds like, it reminds me a lot of the Red Hood in Batman. Jason Todd and Bruce Wayne. So now Lila's talking to Dia. He said, no, it looks like you just took down Diaz's operation. It sounds like a lot of collateral damage. Do you need to destroy his relics? So I was like, I'm planning to take as much as I can here. When I realized, so Lila, you must have told Lila, or you must have got information of it. She's gonna be sorry. He said, you okay? I'll try. Hey, DJ. Yeah, so he might just be a BA just like his pops and mom. One more stunt man about some other people. Explanation. So he might, so this may be him telling the crew about, hey, I've been taking this drug that was supplied by Ricardo Diaz, the dragon. So we see. Oh, that's funny. So you see William and Felicity playing a video game. And Oliver walks in the door. Alright, you weren't going that long, I know. So what happened with your friend? You found his son. That's good. Science Friday didn't. Felicity made him say that he could eat ice cream for dinner. So the kid is a whiz now. I mean, I could tell William's going to be a BA just like his pops. And his stepmother. She says the ice cream was like a road and it had nuts in. So technically, it's your protein's protein. Smart. So it's like a happy ending. It's a long story. It's a sad story. I learned something. I made the relationship. Not just being a greener. For women and for me. Well, but yeah, but John is still. Oh, my. He said, if you go to the roof and show how it works, in the middle of a kiss. It's a non-emergency, but you get to the. You get to the bunker. He said, please say, how about later? family moment with Oliver. What would I have to say? That's a funny movie coaster. That's rock bottom. I should have told you all about this. The truth is about it, man. But you're sorry I didn't. The truth started before the punch on. Yes. That's why I owe you the biggest apology for that. Should have known what was going on before we got to that bridge, man. I probably almost got you killed. I betrayed your trust. But your life's in danger. Well, I can also let you forgive me. I understand if you can. This help wasn't great. But you counted times you saved my life, and by the times you got me killed, you still had. I love these comical little spurts of comedy in these stuff, man. It's really fun. Why not switch to apology because you do that one? Just have to make sure you're back. We're okay. Rip. I'm going to give you one anyway. Then I'll lie to you. And I'm sorry. And I'll make you one more promise. There'll be no more secrets coming from me. No more secrets. She has one of her own. So Dinko walks over to the mantle of the Green Arrow. And his tremor started. You know, I'm glad that Curtis can actually fix and help him with that. He really needs it. So now Watson said he's under arrest. So dude, against her gonna open the Green Arrow's in the prison. So Hayden James is back. Caden James is back and he's gonna wreak havoc. So this is gonna be crazy for next week, bro. I cannot wait. Mr. Bush here speaks.